Congratulations on the show. This is very exciting.
Thank you.
Is based on the fact that you are a doctor in real life. You were a doctor.
Yes, sir. I was a doctor at an HMO in California for 7 years, and everything before I was an actor, and it's such a full circle moment. Everything's coming back.
It's a very nice combination of all things. And also, this show is based on your family as well. You have twin girls.
Yes, Alexa and, God, I forgot it, Zoe.
And your wife, obviously.
And
you have a wife.
Tran, yeah.
There you go.
Yeah.
And now, do you have to run, since it's based on you, it's your name, Dr. Ken, everybody's going to know this is, your wife on the show is obviously drawn from your wife.
Yeah, no,
do you have to run it by her before you use stuff?
I actually do. I mean, if anything, the stuff I bump on as a writer is like stuff that I'm more afraid to reveal, either in our marriage or in our work. My wife is so laid back. She's really cool with a lot of things. I mean, she let me be naked in The Hangover, for Christ's sake.
That's true,
So I just, very, very...
Everything's up from there.
Everything's literally up from there.
And what about your daughters? At 8, can they process that their dad is on television playing a version of himself? Is that something they can process at 8?
Yeah, Alexa, she was definitely saying it's weird to have like a famous actor as a father, and I told her, well, I know it's a lot to live up to. She goes, no, I didn't say a good actor.
You address this in the show that when you were a doctor, people would diagnose themselves via the internet. They would go online. Do you have anything to say about this? Any advice to anybody who's watching who might do that?
You know, as a former doctor, I mean, of course you need to go online to get a lot of information. I do think, like, the National Institutes of Health, like NIH.gov, they give you the most complete explanation of symptoms and disease. Like, anything .gov, .edu that's associated with, like, a medical school is golden. Don't go to a .com or, like, you know, how much do you belch .blogspot or whatever.
Right,
don't do that. But I think something like that's reputable.
Okay, gotcha. But stay away from something.com.
Exactly.
Yeah, okay, good.
Exactly.
And now you actually have to renew your medical license every 2 years, and you still do that.
Yeah, it basically involves me watching a few lectures in like $2,500.
Well, that sounds like
medicine,
a scam.
Boom. No, not a scam.
Do you have friends try to scam you for free medical advice? Like, when you're on set and someone's ill, knowing that you were a doctor, do people hit you up for medical advice?
All the time.
Okay.
Every single movie, every single show I've ever done. I mean, my favorite one was being on the set of Hangover 2. We're in Bangkok.
Uh-huh.
And I'm in my Mr. Chow outfit and with Ed Helms and Zach and Bradley, and I'm saying all these horribly politically incorrect things in front of a seedy strip joint in Bangkok, and I'm like, stupid mother, and then literally Ed gives me his phone. Oh, stupid mother. Oh, hi, is this Chris? Oh my God, you have food poisoning? Oh God, well, you should go to an ER really quick. Are you allergic to Cipro or any other quinolone antibiotics? And it was a hush over the room, me as Mr. Chow, almost naked, with everyone look. That is way more jarring than anything I've ever done in The Hangover. I had to go back into the accent to normalize it, you know?
Yeah, right.
I was like, stupid, you know, whatever. You know. Reset that.